what makes the urban economy work. Secondly, they don't understand what the goals and purposes of SMEs. And lastly, they know nothing about the economy. So firstly, let's talk about the local culture and how the local industry works. You have to understand that if you were to go to Malaysia, it's really the place where I see multi-racial diversity. What Singapore has in terms of the comparative advantage is that we are able to blend in the cosmopolitan field that our advanced economy has conferred upon our citizens over there. But what is even more important is that when you mix the multi-racial identities, it goes to show that your culture is something that evolves and something that is very fluid, that you take into account the latest developments in your society as well as the economy. Secondly, we also have to argue that they have just shot themselves in the foot by saying that the problem with the local industry really is that Singaporeans no longer want to spend their time in these kopitiams as a store helper over there. That has nothing to do with like people not visiting the kopitiam, because there are many kopitiams out there. In fact, it's expanding in terms of scope. Now we see that in almost every shopping center as an alternative to all the fast food restaurants that we've already seen over there. So if you really want to solve that problem, then you really have to get to reverse the Singapore education policy that discourages our people, our students, from spending time helping their parents as compared to, like, for example, focusing on like getting a degree and getting into a professional job. Next, they really don't understand what SMEs really bring to the economy over here. SMEs, yes, they do play a role in the industry, but ultimately they are limited by certain factors. Like for example, at the end of the day, the kopitiam store can only hire maybe 2 to 3 helpers over there as compared to Starbucks. And the reason why Starbucks has hired more people, because it's a value-added industry. It not only creates the coffee or bends the coffee, but also has to create a nice ambience for the rest of people. That is how you provide jobs and opportunities for your service industry over there. And the last thing that I want to say is that, look, some of these SMEs are actually not profitable from this country over here, because increasingly, if you take a look over Singapore, S11, kopitiam, banquet, and so on and so forth, they are trying to become conglomerates over there. That at the end of the day, they are hiding behind the guise of the SMEs, but earning the profit of an MNC over there. So that is a moot point anyway, right? Because they are becoming more and more like MNCs. I can't really see how they come to this. But the worst thing that they did today is they really don't understand what the economy is. They use the term fiscal lack of prudence. But what really is fiscal lack of prudence over there? Is it really like the wrong choices in terms of the US Fed? Or is it other choices when it comes to bubble assets? Let me just explain it very quickly. What we stand for today is like, for example, what the US is coming to do, like the government resuscitating the economy by building up the bank so that there's liquidity, there's money flowing to the economy. What you're standing for is a monetary policy where we keep interest rates low so that people are more willing to spend rather than to save in the bank. What we are okay with is that the government stimulus package that leads to infrastructure spending, because we all understand that when our economy is very flaccid, what you really need is more activity over there. What we are not okay with is when people start to think in terms of individual choices, how it benefits them. And that leads me to my main point of sustainability. What I'm going to talk about today is that how, as an individual, it's not just a smart thing for you to spend on Starbucks, but it's also your duty as a citizen, as a duty to the economy to do so. Right, it sounds quite weird, but I'm going to do so. Every debate needs a principle, and I'm going to stand by this. We have a duty to society because we recognize that we are the products of society. The reason why we can earn a living is because we receive the education. The reason why we can earn a living is because of the infrastructure as well as the laws that govern society. Correspondingly, we have a responsibility back to society, and often is paid in terms of taxes. But then the question they're going to ask is, why are taxes not enough? And I'm going to answer it afterwards.
I think your duty is not to support this highly powerful, highly rich TNT, but that to the local beverage industry like the kopitiam.
The balance is already in favor of these local companies because they sell it at a cheaper price. Like what you mentioned is a comparison between $6.50 and a dollar over there. What we are arguing is that the middle class and the upper middle class, people who can afford it, should take on the responsibility of paying more, because these MNCs are useful to our company. These MNCs are not there because they are an international brand, but they are there because they can hire a lot of our Singaporeans. They are there because they can pay a lot of our Singaporean corporate taxes. So that I promised over there that the duty is largely fulfilled by the payment of taxes.
But in many countries, like for example in Singapore or even in the United States, we are talking about like countries trying to have tax cuts on the middle and upper middle class, which goes to show that individuals are no longer contributing to the economy as much as they used to be. And this is something that is important, because at the end of the day, if the richer people, which like the backbone of the economy is always the middle and upper middle class, if they are not contributing their fair share to the economy, then we really do not see how society can progress when it comes to economic development, both for long term and short term. They don't understand culture, they don't understand amenities, and they definitely don't understand.